Hello, welcome to Daily Hope, Bethel Church's daily devotions. Well, happy Memorial Day to you. Today, we will be honoring and remembering men and women who have selflessly sacrificed their own lives for the benefit of you and I so that we can enjoy freedom. And so if you're listening to this today on Memorial Day, join me in remembering those who have given their lives in the service of our military. Today, I especially remember two men in my life who have passed on. One is my grandfather, Inez Barba, who served in the United States Army during World War II, and my father-in-law, Edward De La Rosa, who served in the United States Navy during the Vietnam War. Both have passed on, and I do miss them dearly, but it's on days like this especially that I remember them and the memories that I have. And I'm grateful for the time that they served with our military. Today, as we remember those who have given the ultimate sacrifice in their lives, we also remember that they sacrificed even more than that, giving the best years of their life in the military to benefit those who maybe may never know their name. They gave up settling down, having to move from base to base whenever they were instructed to do so. And they sacrificed so much for us. And so today, we've set aside a day to remember them and to honor them. And one verse that comes to mind when I think about those who have given their lives for us is in John, where Jesus talks about how greater love hath no man than the man who has given his life for his friend. Let me read that scripture to you. It's in John 15, 13. It says, "There is no greater love than to lay down one's life for one's friend." Jesus is recognizing the tremendous sacrifice that one friend may give to another friend when he gives his life for his friend. And Jesus is recognizing the honor and the sacrifice of those who had given their lives in the past, but I believe Jesus is also given a foreshadowing of the sacrifice that he is going to be giving very soon with his own life. But Jesus even takes it up a notch in terms of sacrifice, because Jesus gives his life not only for those who are his friends, but Jesus gives his life for those who are his enemies, those who put him on the cross. He gave his life for those who would be rebelling against him and intentionally turning their backs upon him at every turn. And Jesus still went to the cross and gave his life for them, sacrificed for them. I would say if you gave your life for a friend, as Jesus said, that's great love. But the sacrifice that Jesus made, I would say that is the greatest love. And one of my favorite passages of Scripture is found in Romans chapter 5, verse 8. I'm going to read that to you. It says, "But God showed his great love for us by sending Christ to die for us while we were still sinners." I love that passage of Scripture, because it tells me that Jesus knows that I'm not perfect, and yet he still gave his life for me. In other words, I wasn't worthy for the sacrifice that Jesus made for me, but he still did it because he loves me. And today we may feel that way about those who have sacrificed with their own lives and given up so much for their own families for our benefit. And what do we do? How do we say thank you? How do we repay? The best thing we can do is to remember them, honor them, and thank them on every occasion. And so today, I encourage you to do that on Memorial Day, thanking those. If you know any Gold Star families, make sure you say thank you to them. Anybody who is in our military, sacrificing a family in the military, remember to thank them and always remember them and their sacrifice. That is what we can do. I'd like to encourage you to also go back. If you missed it, Pastor Frank had a wonderful message about honor on Memorial Day. You can find that on Bethel's YouTube channel at Bethel Church SJ. Great message. If you missed it, go back and watch it. If you saw it, I encourage you to share it with another. Thank you so much for watching today. I pray that you have a wonderful rest of your day on Memorial Day. God bless you.